start with some breaking news coming out of Melbourne right now, where a police officer has tested positive for COVID-19. Let's go straight to Today Melbourne reporter Christina Hearn. And Chris, what are the details?
Ali, I can confirm that a police officer working at the Werribee Police Station has tested positive to COVID-19. Police were notified on Wednesday of the positive test. This officer has been on leave since the 21st of June. The station was closed for a deep clean. It has reopened this morning. Six police officers believed to be close contacts of this particular officer have been told to self-isolate for 14 days. Inquiries are currently underway to find out just how this officer contracted COVID-19 and whether indeed they had any contact with the public while they were infectious.
Geez, that's a big one with contact tracing, isn't it, Chris? And this, of course, comes as pressure grows for answers to the hotel quarantine scandal.
Yeah, that's right, Ali. The Victorian government is pouring $3 million into a judicial inquiry into the hotel quarantine mess, but that is not enough for the state opposition, who is calling on the health minister to be sacked. This comes after a whistleblower speaking on the Today Show blew the lid on the lack of training that security officers were given before working in hotel quarantine. Since then, other guards have come forward, making allegations such as security staff working as Uber and taxi drivers in between their shifts at hotel quarantine, potentially spreading the virus. It is because of this hotel quarantine mess that 36 suburbs find themselves in lockdown this morning. There'll be more police officers out and about doing checkpoint-style operations to make sure everyone is doing the right thing. If they don't, of course, they do face big fines. And it does also come as an infectious disease expert warns that more suburbs are most likely going to go into lockdown after we recorded 77 new cases in Victoria yesterday. Ali?
Yes, plenty of talk about that today. Thank you, Chris.
And we now know that Victoria's virus crisis has breached the borderlines with confirmed COVID-19 cases in Sydney and the Northern Territory connected to Melbourne's hotel quarantine bungle. Now to today's Sydney reporter, Gabrielle Boyle at Balmain in Woolworths. Gabby, it was there that a worker returned a positive result.
Yeah, quite a complicated situation when it comes to tracing back exactly who needs to be tested and who's been exposed, David. And that's because the Bangladeshi Australian man returned on June 1. He went into quarantine and 4 days after that, he was found to be carrying COVID-19. It was 10 days after that in Victoria that he was released and he travelled back here home to New South Wales and started back at work at Woolworths here working at the self-service checkout. It was then that he again tested positive. 50 staff members from Woolworths have been sent home to be tested. Anyone that's believed to have come in contact with this man should also be tested. So the message is to be really vigilant for those signs and symptoms of COVID-19 if you're living in this area. David?
All right, thanks for that, Gabby.
It's Freedom Friday in Queensland, at least anyway, with a new round of restrictions easing just in time for the weekend. Jessica Millward is at Brisbane Airport. Jess, good morning. It's not such good news for anyone arriving from Victoria, though.
No, that's right. Anyone who is coming from Victoria into Queensland have just a few hours to get into the Sunshine State, because if they arrive after midday, they will be forced into 14 days quarantine at their own expense. So there are three flights bound to be pretty full coming from Melbourne into Brisbane, and they will be the last remaining travellers that get to do so without quarantining. That is the bad news. The good news is from midday today, there is going to be a significant easing of restrictions in Queensland. Among them, 50% capacity at stadiums, concerts and theatres, 100 guests at weddings, funerals and private gatherings, including house parties. Reopening today, casinos, nightclubs, food courts, spas and saunas. And instead of the person limit, we will move to a one person per 4 square metre rule for cafes, pubs, clubs and restaurants. Those smaller venues will have one person per 2 square metres to make things viable for them. Police warn that they will be out checking that people are complying. But Alex, Queensland, get ready to party, social distancing style.
Look out, the Forex will be flying. You knew your maroon jacket there too.